So hello and welcome to Jokkmokk and Swedish Lapland and to my Northern Panorama channel. Today I'm on skis. This is what I call a bonus day because I had not planned to go out, but according to the forecast there maybe will be clear later this night. So I can already see some stars, but there are also some a little bit of snow in the air, but we'll see. I'm quite close to the town, Jokkmokk, so this is not the Bortel 1 or 2, it's probably around Bortel 3, but pretty good anyway. And it's not that cold today, it's minus 15, 20 or something like that. You know. I got some company here. Oh. Dog sled. Traffic chaos. Yeah, I'm fine. I'm doing an astrophotography movie. So this was a little unplanned adventure. Stina from Jokkmokk Guiderna, guide company here in Jokkmokk, came with some dog sleds, sled dogs. And the line from the dogs hooked up in my gear back there. So I digged a hole here in the snow. I have arrived to the small shelter here at the shore of Lille Skabram Lake outside Jokkmokk. So I will put up my gear here and see if the sky will clear. There you can see the shelter. The sky looks promising. I can see a lot of stars now. My plan is to put up my gear here and shoot M81 and M82 and add data to a set that I shot a couple of weeks ago. Okay, so I have my gear here in this sledge. Or pulka is the Swedish word. A little bit of snow here. We'll dig a spot for my mount. Now I have tilted this tripod a few degrees because I'm around 66 degrees north here at Jokkmokk, north of the Arctic Circle. So we actually have the Arctic Circle about 7 kilometers south of town. Now I will connect everything, see, so it works, and then do a polar alignment. Oh, this is Stina. Oh, okay. Hi. Okay. I have connected everything and have done a polar alignment and I have focused manually. So I will soon start to shoot at the M81 and M82. M81, Bode's galaxy with its large galactic core. I think it's a very beautiful object. Together with the peculiar looking M82, the starburst galaxy, it's a spectacular pair. I shot them
a couple of weeks ago, but I will add some data on them tonight, is my plan. This is actually a little bit short focal length for galaxies, and I have, before this, I have only done the M81. But I think M81 and M82 fits quite nice on this field of view. But I also want a longer focal length, so I can go out hunt for smaller galaxies. Okay, and now I will start the shooting, and I think I will make a fire. The temperature had dropped, so I think it's could be around minus 20 now. Begin to feel pretty cold. When I sit like this out in the wild, in front of a warming fire with a dark sky over me, I can feel a connection to the stars and to our ancestors. It was like this they experienced the night sky, crisp and clear, but with vague conceptions of what they saw. It must have been so incredibly inconceivable. All stars like burning campfires far, far away. And today we know more, but the more we know, the more questions we also get. So I remember when I was a child and read Carl Sagan's Cosmos, and he wrote that we are all standing on this tiny shore of this giant cosmic ocean. And I think we all can perceive that feeling sometimes deep inside of us. And when I'm out like this, all alone, just me and the stars, that feeling becomes so strong. And down there I have my mount, my rig, photographing ancient photons that have been traveling for 12 million years. Pretty cold now. It must be in under minus 20 degrees. It was just 15 or something when I left, began skiing, but now it's quite cold. So I will begin to ski back and add this set of images to the ones that I did a couple of weeks ago. So I have been sitting here at the campfire feeling a little bit philosophical. But now I will pack my gear and begin to ski back. It's only a few kilometers, so it will take half an hour or something. Then back home and take a warm bath, I think. Fjällpulken, Norwegian brand. And here, back where I started, so I have my car behind the camera. And it was pretty cold over the ice when I skied back, so I had to keep on moving, not to be too cold. So it's probably around under minus 20 degrees now. And the best warmth when you are out like this comes from inside of you. So if you start to begin feeling a little bit cold, the best thing is to start moving. So I don't actually have so a lot of clothes on me now. I have a merino wool inner shirt and then a little thicker merino wool with a hood. And shell jacket in cotton. My thin gloves, they are perfect when I when I ski. The other one gets too warm, and if you gets too warm and begin to sweat when it's cold like this, you will start freezing directly when you stop. It could be dangerous. And I have a nice beer. So what to say more? Probably not the best night for astrophotography ever. The moon is up and has been quite strong, and but it was pretty clear, and I think I've collected, as I said, 1.5 hour on M81 and M82. I like these small trips, an ordinary Tuesday evening. But now I will go home.
Hello. Yesterday was not the best evening for astrophotography ever, but it was a nice evening trip with some exercise too. And it's always nice to spend some time in front of a campfire. I also had an opportunity to test the focuser modification that I did in the kitchen last week, and it seems to work fine. I collected some time on M81 and M82, however I have not stacked those images yet, and the image that you will see soon is from a session I did a couple weeks ago. And as I said yesterday, I think M81 and the M82 are a very beautiful pair of galaxies, and this is also a very interesting region of the sky. These are only a few of the more prominent galaxies in this region, and because of their declination at about 69 degrees, they are very well suited to shoot at from such a high latitude as where I am located. With more integration time, it would also be possible to catch a very faint integrated flux nebulosity. This kind of nebulosity has been described as, and now I read beforehand, high galactic latitude nebula that are illuminated not by a single star as most nebula in the plane of the galaxy are, but the energy from the integrated flux of all the stars in the Milky Way. These nebula clouds, an important component of the interstellar medium, are composed of dust particles, hydrogen and carbon monoxide and other elements. So this is a very interesting region, and in the future I will give it a lot more time to see if I can catch this faint and elusive nebulosity. Well, that was all for this time, so goodbye from Jokkmokk, Swedish Lapland, and don't forget to subscribe to my channel if you want to share my Arctic astrophotography adventures.